was actually really hearing entities coming through and talking with me. These were my higher guides. I trained horses. I loved horses. I was crazy about horses when I was about 5 or 6. And then on my 6th birthday, my dad bought me a pony. And that was it. That was when I started working with horses. And throughout that time, I realized that I had been guided to work with the animals on their level. And so, and all around me, if any of you have been in the horse industry or anywhere, there's a lot of abusive people when it comes to dealing with large animals. Because partly they have a little bit of what, you know, with that fear of they've got to overtake this, you know, this beast of burden and make them work for them. And that's just not the way it needs to be. You're basically, you know, convince the animal that, you know, you're going to work with them, that whole thing. So by the time I was 12, I was doing remedial training. And doing that with a lot of help and spirit. So 13 to 15 in there is where I started to read tarot, and my aunt, who knows what automatic writing is? There anybody know? My aunt sat down and wrote me a 2-page letter explaining exactly who my guides were, why I am the way I am, and that I have many lives in the Native family groups, so mostly North American, Native American. My main guide, his name is Tara, who is actually Aborigine, so I can't sit there and claim I've got a big Native American, you know, chief so-and-so, my spirit guide. No, I've got Tara. He can be a little pushy and a little mean at times, but, you know, that's how he is. I study mostly the higher esoteric arts, Native beliefs, a lot of Native beliefs, and especially like when it comes to making my sage things and learning to deal with herbs and the plants and the numens, which are the plant spirits that are in them. And numen actually, I think, is an old one. I learned that from the Strega. So the Strega is old, like Italian, sort of the old religion. And they talk about how you don't have to have an animal as something that can be your guiding spirit animal. It can also be a plant. And so the spirit that the plant can be too. So, let's see. Native studies, nature, religions, and occult is what I have studied because that's where a lot of the old stuff stayed alive, was in the occult, you know. And nowadays, that's not such a bad word anymore, is it? So, that's very cool. My focusing tools, I use inspirational cards, not necessarily a tarot deck. Right now, I'm weaning myself off the cards. You know, I want to grab on them like they're a blanket to, so I feel comfortable and safe with my cards, but I know I don't need them anymore. I do automatic writing. I do use a Ouija board, but we do it in a safe way. We know how to cleanse the board, we know how to go out and ground the board, and we know how to call the higher entities in there of the light and not the funky things that reside in the lower astral. We don't need that. We need good light things, and that's in people and the energies and the elementals and all the good things, and that's what comes to where we live. We have a place called World Magic, our house, but we have a meeting group called World Magic Circle Learning Center, and every Monday we have group meetings, and without fail, people show up, and whether I'm sick or not, we are having that meeting, and so we do a lot with, we use the Ouija board during that time sometimes, and then we use animal shamanism. And how many of you guys have studied anything on that? You know anything about? Yeah. I mean, right now I'll tell you, I'm going through a transformation period. I mean, I woke up and there's this big moth right above my head, and moths and butterflies are transformation. So, what I've got on my little board here that I made from stuff from thrift stores is. This is what I got from Webster's Dictionary, which is psychic, which is belonging to the soul, or psyche on physical now, and then medium, which is an agency of transmission. So I can tell you right now that we have people here, but there's far more dead people here. I mean, they can cram so many people into a room, it's, you know, and they love to feel that good, happy energy. That's why I wanted you guys to feel good and feel clean, because they're going to be coming in while they're here already. So, an agency of transmission. Has anybody been to a medium here? Cool. Okay, I'm going to apologize right now. I suck at names, okay? Some of those mediums, they can pull them out, they're like boom, boom, boom. And you know what? I get more, I'm going on wanted to talk to his friend that was his buddy in the Navy, and I didn't get that guy. All I felt was wet, soggy feet and combat boots. So I try, you know, and sometimes whoever comes, don't ever come with expectations because you can't always pull everything out. You guys have been to mediums, you know that. So basically what we have is soul sight beyond the visible now, okay? Because the physical now is what we're doing. We're all living. This is an illusion. We're all scrambling, and you know, this is mostly a negative world we're in. So let's try to be positive, because that's the only thing that gets us through are the good times, enjoy, and bliss, and keeping our energies high. So we've got clairvoyance. This is what I guess I am. I'm a clairvoyant, which is clairseeing. Clairaudient is clairhearing. When I have entities come in, I can hear, you know, they talk. It's not even like really hearing them. Clear seeing. Yeah, I get some good stuff there with these guys. Some of them, I'll tell you the story in a minute. That was crazy the other night. And clairsentience is clear feeling, which means that an entity can tell you, okay, this is how I died, or this is how I passed, or this is how this person who is living makes me feel, and this is how we're close together. Okay. And I do spirit guide readings, which means my guys talk to your guys, we all have powwow, it's great. Ascended Masters. You guys know what Ascended Masters are? Okay. Some people are really good at pulling out who they know who they're talking to, but not me. I just start writing, and they start telling me what I need to write. And so I'm just, you know, I can hear them talking, and that's how it goes. Life path readings, this is your average, everyday, you know, what kind of toenail polish should I put on, you know, or something like that, you know. Am I going to do okay this next job? Am I? That kind of thing. Departed loved ones, that's our mediumship. And what ifs? What ifs are always fun. You know, what if? What if this were to happen? And so this is sort of what I'm about. I'm always growing and learning and evolving. And that's why I hope that I really get some good contact information for you guys. Because the last time we did our spirit social, I actually walked into my garage 2 days later and there was a man smoking a cigar sitting on my couch. And he said, tell my daughter I said hi. And I didn't know who his daughter was. And it turned out that after we took the pictures of the orbs, there's Thyndale investigators in Carson City, their paranormal investigation team. What we do is we send our orb pictures to them, they blow them up, and they have an entire system of categorizing orbs, and they can see what's in them. And so when you guys go, if you have, you know, computer access, you can go on my website and click on my photo book. And you can see, I've got faces. There's faces and little tongues sticking out. They're making silly little things. Some of them have lettering. Some of them have, you know, like fractal images in them. And they're great. And so that's what I wanted to do. So this whole thing with the spirit socials are getting bigger and bigger. And the more, after I do them, the more ideas come to me. And I email you guys. And I let you know, hey, this is what happened. This is what's going on. If you want digital images, you send them through email. If you don't have a computer, you write down your address. We will print them out for them with the explanations underneath. And I think that is just so cool, because with this man that came in with the cigar, it turned out that the woman that did the orb, she goes, there was a man with a cigar there, and he was talking about some, and she heard it too. She heard Karen, and I heard Karen when I got home. And I had no Karen to contact. So when things come through, we want to really be able to get messages to you, because they will come afterwards sometimes. Because, you know, their timing's all off. Yeah, that sort of thing. These are some of the pictures. You can't really see this one too well, but this one, we took Jess and I do tribal belly dance, and we were dancing and just farting around, and I started snapping a couple pictures.